talk about what it is we have to do.
Other than... Nope, it looks absolutely fine to her. I don't see jack shit.
So, throughout the night, as you guys were sleeping, I did information from a reliable source.
Uh-huh.
This fog is...
Tharps is way too close to Master.
This fog is completely unnatural. Like, I just looked outside, it should be morning, and it's actually darker than it was before we took our rest.
Well, let me see if I can get some light on this. And as she says that, she's going to do detect magic. Okay. And do you need what to, you know?
Do you before we continue on with anything, Samira, do you remember how we got here, or anything before how we got here?
What? No.
And Chloe looks at both of them. Don't you remember this yellow thing? And she kind of, you know, points to the Abra.
She's like, who's that?
This thing teleported us here. Don't you remember?
No, not really.
And that brings us to the possible second problem. While this fog is unnatural, it seems to be having adverse effects on people. Because Samira is not a forgetful person.
Mm-hmm. True, very true. And this is very...
Wait, how would you know that? Off character, sorry.
I've picked it up from the adventure here.
Or still, what is so far from being caught up, kind of. Maybe.
Because obviously you knew me before, and you remembered a bunch of shit about me.
Not wrong. I know all the things about my master. Well, used to.
So that's why I'm going to...
So, Axel, what do I get from Detect Magic? I think the DM's dead. Or he muted his mic.
I was just still looking at the thing. So basically, you just look and everything is glowing. Just like everywhere you look.
Okay, yep, everything. This thing is definitely magic based. You just hear from Chloe.
So something is creating this unnatural.
You also know that the school of magic is enchantment.
Yeah, this is definitely weird. It's definitely an enchantment. Can't give you any more, but this whole place is going like a disco ball.
I am kind of worried about bringing Catharis and Samira with us, since they seem to have been affected by this fog.
Don't be ridiculous. Who are you?
Why do I have to stay with this guy?
Who are you?
I don't know. Just...
What have you done with Donnie? At which point you just hear quack. But from outside the door.
I open the door to Donnie in.
Donnie doesn't come in, but he looks around and quacks again.
Catharis, good old translator, would you be so kind as to translate what Donnie said?
Who the f*** is Donnie?
You were just asking for Donnie, the duck! Donnie Docco, right there!
Never.
I swear to fucking...
Don't you dare swear to Donnie like that.
Welcome to the side of the map where everything is weird and just stop questioning it.
Why do you keep calling it a duck?
I mean, it
who
is
are
a
you
duck.
People? Donnie, who are these people? Quack. Oh, they're my friends? Quack. Oh, they're. Okay, good to know, Donnie. So Donnie says that this place smells like horse shit. Also, there was a horse in here before, he said.
I don't remember a horse.
The mimic ate it.
Don't tell him.
And Chloe sighs. Like...
The duck also sighs.
Yeah, well, I think we all unanimously to this.
The Arab puts its head to the side and disappears.
And,
Oh, he didn't disappear. Why didn't you disappear?
Now he's gone.
Anyway, Catharsis is gonna say, like, we should figure something out before I forget who you all are again.
Yeah.
All right. We're all friends. We need to figure out what's going on. Fog is unnatural. We need to find the source of said fog. And promptly kill it.
Or convince it to stop. Convincing it to stop is good.
Both of you need a third option.
I got an option. Let me see.
Donnie says we should extort them like pimps.
That's a good option. I like that. It means we get money.
Quack.
Probably.
Gosh. And,
or artifacts. Ooh, powerful. Or magical artifacts. Maybe they got a magical dagger.
And while they're at, while he's literally rambling, can, Chloe do, Divine Sense?
Yes.
Which... You know that, right? Or do I have to send it?
No, I know that one. Let's see. I'm just trying to determine what falls on, because that's the thing. It has such weird categories in some ways. Like, it has Celestials and Fiends and Undead, but it also covers the Hollow Spell, and it would also kind of... Anyway. I mean, aside from detecting the alignments of your people in here, you don't really detect anything. Even the fog itself doesn't seem to be good or evil. It's just, you know, fog. Magical fog. But fog. You do notice that Donnie is 100% neutral. His neutrality knows no bounds. Also, the mimic is hungry. You can just see that. You don't have to, you know, that's not divine.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
Looking at you hungrily.
Oh, no.
It is still, like, nibbling on Catharsis's arm, by the way.
Let's go, mimic. Let's find you some food.
It ate a horse last night. What more does it have to eat?
I really don't think finding food for the mimic should be our top priority right now.
I feel like that's all we ever do anymore. Wait,
and,
I haven't even been here.
Anyway, do I get anything other than what I mean, what I sent you?
In this direction.
No, unfortunately, there doesn't seem to be anything crazy or hollowed within the area.
Rumors that mimic likes bartenders.
Oh, God. Oh, fucking god.
Well, I definitely dance since what it could be. Oh boy.
What these do?
The mimic's stomach grumbles. The fuck is that thing?
Nothing.
It doesn't look like nothing. It looks like a treasure chest.
It is a treasure pet.
Why does it have teeth?
Nom on things, my dear.
I feel like I don't want that thing in my establishment.
Oh, he's fine.
I don't think he is, ma'am.
Just a little hungry.
Yeah, well, I'm sure he is. He has lots of teeth. Now, if you wouldn't mind getting out of here.
Looks down at the mimic to see what he wants to do.
The mimic does not give a fuck about anything. The mimic is hungry. It's looking at you hungrily currently.
No mimic, peaks, bad mimic.
Peeks head in door. Sick him.
Are you trying to get?
Yep.
Make an actual roll for that if you want.
I'm making an animal handling roll.
Okay.
Telling him to stick the bartender and the barmaid.
Oh shit.
Oh shit.
Alright.
Chloe's just like, what the heck are you guys about to do?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Yeah. Yeah, I. What?
Alright, the mimic basically just takes a big chomp out of this woman, just takes her whole arm off, and she's like lying on the ground just screaming for a couple seconds until she dies. The guy is just like, what the fuck, and starts running for the door.
I hold the door shut so he can escape.
He goes to the back door.
Where are you going?
He's gone.
And Chloe looks at Avelio and is like, what did you just do?
Nothing.
There's a big pile of blood on the floor.
Oh, who's a good boy?
And remember, she heard the screaming. That is not joy. A screams of joy. So what the heck happened?
Those were absolutely screams of joy. They were so jubilant. I'm happy about it.
Donnie goes quack. Donnie says that those were absolutely horrified screams of death.
Yeah, I kind of figured. What?
Donnie, you don't know what you're talking about.
Donnie goes quack.
You realize you're gonna have to roll a deception.
Yeah, you have for all of these lies. Basically, you got like five rolls already.
Alright, roll 1d20 for the first one.
It's like, how many did we lie about already? We lied about, oh, well,
three.
She knows you're lying on that one. Well, she has to roll for, intuition, basically. It's a lie versus an intuition check. Man, she's gonna know you're lying a lot on this. Alright, you got some decent ones. Alright, now you gotta roll your intuition on countering those, Jewel. Oh, wow.
But no, she has the fucking halfling bug.
Yes, she does. Well, ah, she already knew you're lying on the very first one.
Well, the first and the second.
To be fair, she didn't even need to because she has that +2. She met it on the first one.
She's just looking at you saying, you wanna tell me the truth or are you just gonna sit here and say that again?
Those were totally jubilant.
Uh-huh. Even Donna don't believe it, I don't believe it, and you're...
Hey, I rolled a 17 on the
line. Okay, if those were jubilant screams...
Yep.
Uh-huh. Then why were you locking the door?
Because it's adult-rated stuff going on in there.
She gives him a look. Like, really?
I mean, technically that's not a lie. That it is kind of adult rated.
And she looks at, how old do I look to you?
Ten?
literally wants to walk over there and kick. You look like she's not amused.
Look, I mean, once you determine he's doing evil, you can do whatever you want.
Do you want to repeat that statement? He literally looks at him, walks up to him.
I feel like that's going to be quite a task that requires a roll, Dfrnt.
Yeah, that is going to require a roll. Just don't get eaten.
Yeah,
that's a good point.
Animal handling.
Yup.
And she's going to it. That's right.
Oh!
Oh!
Yay!
No.
Yay!
She gives you an intimidating look. Will you step aside?
Let's see.
Bite my shiny metal axe!
She's intimidating you.
That's a 19.
I gotta roll a nat 20 here. Damn.
15. She's looking pretty pissed at the 10-year-old college.
Alright, it tries to bite you, but it misses, Dfrnt. You're just lucky that whenever it tries to hit you, I miss.
She's just like, will you kindly.
Like, if it tasted blood, you'd be done for.
You don't want to open that door.
At this point, I don't care. Do you want to get smited, or do you really want me to fight you?
Hit him with a heel.
Don't you dare fucking hit me with a heel.
She's just looking at you like...
I love it too, because it's... Because she fucking can use fucking healing word too. Or lay on hand. She has like three different fucking healing options.
Oh, or smite. Because remember, smite is a radiant.
Oh, man. Alright, so what's going on, Dfrnt? What are you doing now? The mimic has now tried to bite you.
I basically just said no. Bad boy.
Okay, so no
that
check.
That was not for eating.
No handle check. You're just going to say that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I guess I can use my charisma.
And she's like,
I'm about to be like, no, be a good boy.
Okay, let's see. The mimic's like, it's debating.
And
it's like, I find food when I'm around this thing.
And Chloe's just giving Veilios a look, like, step aside as he actually steps.
Alright, I warned you, you don't want to go in there.
Okay.
Oh, hey, Mr. Dumbbeard. What
the fuck going on in there?
Hey,
I heard
I'm
a fucking
about to
scream.
Find out, mister. Sir.
I heard from outside through the fog and down the street.
Can I wipe the floor?
Right? Okay, as she's
what
opening
would
the
that
door.
Would be under? What would cleaning blood off of a surface be under? Stealth? I guess?
Or interacting with an object.
Because I just don't know what other check that would go on.
Performance?
Under. I don't think so. I don't think you can fucking turn that in. You have to have an audience and delight. So no, I don't think that's going for performance. I'm pretty sure it's a fucking stealth check.
The only thing you could think would be it would be sleight of hands.
But sleight of hand is...
I'm trying to do it before
someone, or I don't know. Well, no, it's supposed to be concealing an object on your person. So unless you're trying to put
the
blood
floor.
In, I didn't know you. The floor.
Wait,
was
okay.
Your
how about if I put a rug over? Is there a rug?
I really don't have anything for this. Why miss 3.5?
Alright, how about if I use a perception check to see if there's a rug that I could cover up the blood with?
Okay.
Oh gosh, in the meantime, she opens...
Hey.
Okay.
I have a chance to find the rug first.
Nah, no rug.
Damn it.
And right is, I'm guessing Chloe opens the door or nah?
Pretty much, it doesn't take too much time to get in there. And the mimic is going to go ahead and... Oh no, that's right, it's confused. I forgot that you got away with that one, because I cannot roll worth shit whenever it attacks or tries to fight you. It's just like, oh, I'll just roll a crit fail for that, so it's just gonna go ahead and be passive, even though it should never be passive. It's a fucking
It will
move.
Love me.
It will. By blind luck, by the end of this adventure, either it will love you or you will both be dead. There's no in between.
Yeah.
And
Chloe!
Can I just charm the hell out of it? Can you love me? Stop trying to eat me.
Dottie just goes quack.
And
it shakes his
Chloe
head.
Chloe's like, can I get a translation for that?
A guitarist says that he can't believe Donnie would say such a thing in polite company.
So Chloe opens the door.
Mimic,
probably a shit show mess.
And like its tongue sticks out. So Chloe just basically comes into the mimic with blood covering it still, by the way, with its tongue sticking out, looking up at Samira.
Okay, what did you just do?
I did nothing.
This is true. That's technically true. She did not do that.
Okay, why is there a mimic covered in blood?
When is he not covered in blood?
He's generally when he has eaten something, and I did hear screams.
Anyone could have screamed.
That lonely kid is like a practicing on how to lie without fucking actually lying. The king of and queen of misdirection now. It's like I can't roll
now
for
this
shit.
This is gonna be
so
funny. This is a deception roll, isn't it? Because she's trying to
She's technically not lying yet. She's
I'm
bending the
though.
Truth, so she's not lying yet.
Okay.
It's a very weird line. That technically I could still make her because she's still trying to conceal the truth, but she's technically not lying. She's just bending the truth.
That would be a deception check. You can convincingly hide the truth or
verbally
or
through
your
actions. You can encompass anything from others. Oh, yeah, through ambiguity to telling outright allies. Yeah, I guess it does. I told you they've really like locked in a lot of these side like categories, because now that says it's that, it's not anything else. But that means like
Sorry,
deception
Nancy.
Doesn't go
Why
to other things either.
Because I kind of want to do this right.
I did 16. Okay. So, wait, where's the bartender and the barmaid?
Hey, I just did a deception test.
Yeah, you did for the one lie.
Yeah, but why was she still asking?
Because you answered the question on why the thing was in blood, but that's one of the many questions. That's why the specific questions or the general answers are important. You got to cover them all. So, like, when you replied, you should have replied, oh, the mimic is covered in blood because I spilled blood all over it, and the bartender and the barmaid all left, and she would have had to believe all of that to be true. Now, she just has to believe the first part to be true. Once again, she is. It's weird because she's telling her what she wants to know. She's just not telling the specifics. So there is a difference between lying and this hiding things specifically.
Of course.
Oh damn, Dfrnt's doing good.
Alrighty.
Yeah, versus
so,
someone that didn't.
Although I really should make you take disadvantage on these rolls since it's fucking covered in blood and there's blood all over the floor.
Yes.
So if we're gonna do it right, let's do it right. You're gonna have to make another roll. If we're gonna do it the right way, we gotta do it all the way right. So you only gotta beat it one more time. No, she didn't beat it again. She was so close.
Rude.
So Chloe has an inkling now, definitely is suspicious and knows you aren't telling the truth about where the bartender went.
Okay.
Also,
so
Gnomebeard is going to do the same thing. He's like, what the fuck's going on in there?
It looks like something had a freaking field day in here.
Also, he's talking to you, Michael. He's like, what the fuck's going on in there?
Some adult-rated stuff.
In which Chloe looks back at him like, really? Are you really here going to-
He's like, I want specifics. What the fuck is going on in my bar? What are you doing in there after I let you sleep in my stable?
I'm not the guilty party here. I'm the one that's asking the questions as much as you are. As well as... Seriously, you've got-
For a rug again! You got the same roll as last time, basically. Oh no, it's a better roll, but there's no rug.
Seriously, how old do we all look that are smaller than you?
Well, he doesn't look as young considering he has a beard. I'm gonna say he's probably about in his 20s.
Who, no beard?
Yep.
Shit, I think it's the one check, but...
In which,
this gnome is about 200 years old.
So he's looking at you like, really? Did you just...
Donnie's just gonna be like, quack.
I gain a little tension of panic. There's a rogue mimic in the bar!
Really?
Alright, that's right. Still a lie because it's not rogue. You ordered it to do that.
Yeah, in which you do realize two.
Oh, hey, look at that there! He's like.
Yeah, that is a.
And hey, look at who didn't roll like shit for once. He looks at you, he's like, bullshit. Don't lie to me.
Both
you
of them
suck at lying.
There is a mimic in the bar.
Yeah, but...
He's like, well, I can believe that.
Up, Meg?
How'd it get there? What happened? Where's Geronica?
What is your involvement in this?
Which one's that one for, Dfrnt?
I tried to charm the mimic into going out the door.
She looks at Samara. And
with
you
a
hold
nine.
It there with that.
God damn it! I cannot roll for this mimic. The mimic is just going to follow you, not out of charmingness, but just out of, you know, like, it's still hungry and food.
Let's go find that bartender.
In which, I swear. In which, you left Veilios out to dry, didn't you? Like, really?
Emma's been mad at Veilios.
She has for a little while. She's slowly falling out of love for Mastered.
Yeah, but you've loved it to two people, the paladin and the bar owner.
Guitars is gonna look up and he's gonna be like, I had nothing to do with this. I'm trying to leave. And Gnome Beers is gonna be like, yeah, I believe you. You take Donnie, get the fuck out of here.
To be honest, I just want to figure out what the fuck's going on with this fog and find the source of it to get rid of it. But other things happened.
Uh-huh.
What other things?
Exactly. Would you care to take it?
Can you just tag me through it step by step? I have a nice bar establishment with two amazing employees who have worked with me for 10 years.
Well, possibly one.
What do you mean? Did someone quit?
You could say they quit.
What would you say?
They're taking a very long vacation?
What does that mean?
Could you explain to this, sir?
Swimming with the fishies?
But there are no lakes around here.
They're taking the long nap.
But they don't even like to nap.
And, Chloe...
They're dead!
Wah! Wah! Wah!
mimic?
Yes, but how?
What do you mean how?
How did a mimic get into my bar? They don't even have hands to open doors.
Yeah, don't you?
The door was left open?
Bullshit.
Yeah, she's just looking at him while he's saying all this work.
Also, you need to roll for the deception on all of this.
Yeah.
Is it animal handling or is it
how about charisma? Those?
Animal handling or charisma?
Either one. Alright, let's see. How did you do on this one? Oh, hey. So I met it. Alright. He's like, that's bullshit.
Ever since you got that horse, you've been very...
Oh, the mimic is just like, meh. It goes back this down this way.
Fine. Follows.
Okay, one of our companions may have a pet mimic that has an extremely insatiable appetite.
Oh, look, the bartender.
What the fuck?!
Yeah.
And it may have eaten a horse in the stable.
My horse Buttercup? Why?
I know, right? Such an unbelievable... seriously.
Don't worry, we'll make right by this. We'll figure out what's causing the fog and we'll get it removed.
How will that replace the lives of my subordinates? Jeremy and Jeronica.
Well, I heard one scream. I don't know what happened to the other one.
Well, where is he then? If he's had only one... What happened?
And she does let him through.
He's just looking, he's like, why? Why? There's still pieces of body on the floor.
So that means there's only one that got eaten alive, but still...
Where is the damn mimic? I'm calling the town guard.
Okay, I'm sorry, you don't have to... Do we need all of these thrown into prison?
He didn't say anything about prison. He said town guard.
Yeah, what do you think comes afterwards? He kind of looks at him. Like, what do you think comes after?
I don't know if we have a town
guard. Tea and crumpets?
This guy's an idiot.
Yes, he is.
The average just shakes its head.
Yeah. Which, yeah.
Hey, Abra. Our little yellow monster, you want to teleport that gnome away? Huh?
And Chloe gives him a look.
You
like,
could
gives,
try to convince him, but I wouldn't suggest it.
I did it anyways.
Yes, you did. And you Whee! And Abra disappear.
And Chloe's just like,
Where the fuck did he go? What is going on here?
Why did I have to take up this job with those? Why was I stuck with them?
And make your fortitude and wisdom save.
Just her or the both of us?
Both.
Yeah, because you're both in the town.
Oof. Double oof. Triple oof. Man, I just used all of my shitty rolls.
Okay, so she's exhausted again.
Indeed.
And when she is just sighing, and just feels, well, this is definitely a lot draining, more draining than it needs to be. I am sorry again, she kind of says
Did you
to the
do
gnome.
Your second roll, Dfrnt?
It's going, it's just...
Oh, it just takes time. Oh, unfortunate.
Oh. And she looks at the gnome just like... Yeah, I'm sorry about this. And honestly, yeah. I can't say that I can replace everything, but it's just that I'm sorry. She kind of says.
He's like, I'm going to find the authorities. You stay here. You're my only witness now that yellow thing took that jackass away.
Yeah.
Oh, Jeremy and Jeronica.
Probably I did hear only a female's voice, a female scream.
Well, where's Jeremy?
Maybe
Jeremy is Jeremy.
Probably ran through the back door. It makes sense.
That's right. I'm gonna go look for him now.
Hopefully soon, because I did see her and that mimic go that way.
Why would you say that before?
Maybe
you,
I was dealing
with young lady with the mimic.
Me?
Yes. Stay right there.
Why?
No reason.
I'd rather not.
You better though.
Come along, mimic. I don't know what that guy's yelling about. Walks back to the inn.
Oh, actually, you gotta make another roll for the mimic.
Oh.
Apologies, you gotta. Damn, oh, well.
Right.
Yeah, no, you're good.
My mimic. Stop trying to tear us apart, man.
I'm not trying to tear you apart. You don't have the adequate skills to care for a mimic.
So? I'll make him love me.
That won't keep him from starving to death or eating you. You can love a pet tiger. That doesn't... Why must we hurt the ones we hit?
Oh, hi, Chloe.
And the cheese looks at Sam is like, don't you... Seriously, you're coming back after you've made a mess?
Huh? What are you talking about?
She points to the mimic. She's like, he ate the barmaid. Or
what?
Someone.
He did not. I've been with him this whole time.
And she got, is the blood still on his
Yes.
Mouth?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, so she pointing to the blood. Then what's that from? Because there's no animal within a mile of here. Or wherever the heck.
He did eat a horse last night, and he's always covered in blood. What are you talking about?
But I would think the blood was dried by the morning. And plus, the bark owner was not so pleased that his horse Buttercup was eaten.
Oh, I mean, sorry, not sorry. He thought Mimic needed to eat. Last night.
What possessed you? Seriously, I understand you get into that thing, but seriously, you just had it eat a bar. Would Veilios have it eat a someone in this bar? Which was either the bar? Yes!
No, he didn't.
Okay, then what is this all this mess for? And she kind of points out all the blood splatters and pieces of maybe whoever.
Oh, I don't know, I just got here.
No, you were here before.
Speaking of, these look like good parts, you should feed it to the mimic.
Stop!
Except the parts.
Put that down!
What? He needs to eat.
Yeah!
No. The mimic.
And she's looking like... Chloe's just looking at her like, you do realize... You can get in serious trouble for this. You as well.
Is tired of listening to her.
And you point. I really don't want to do this.
This way, guys. There's absolutely got to be a bitch over here with the mimic. I know I saw.
She's always yapping.
There was blood and body parts all over my bar. It was terrible.
Let's see. You haven't eaten all morning. Let's go see. Find you another snack.
And the Haber brings Michael back.
In which Chloe is like, well, at least we got someone that will prove my statement. As well as... And she's like, hello, bartender. A barkeeper. Bar... Not bartender, barkeeper.
Bar owner.
Bar owner.
Alright, let's see.
Thank you. Gnome beard.
There'll be one. I love that you're just out here just killing the town. With a pet mimic. About to get everyone killed! I'm no longer sorry for this. I am no longer sorry for your poor decisions and the consequences. That's all I gotta say.
Well, Chloe listened. So I think she's not gonna be too screwed over.
And Over's like, alright, I'm here. These ones, all of them, they were with her. Figure it out, boys.
I grab onto the yellow monster. Teleport me away again!
It teleports, but it does not take you.
No!
In which Chloe is like, really? You didn't think your actions had consequences?
I didn't.
You?
Do
oh, really?
What's going on here? This man tells us that you all had a pet mimic and that you ate one of his employees. She was my fiance. You just hear from one of the guys in the back.
I didn't eat one of the employees.
And it's not my pet mimic.
Well, then you won't mind going in handcuffs down to the local courthouse, which is also the town hall, because it's a small town.
Yeah, I don't mind. I mean, I haven't done anything wrong.
You know, I like you. I believe you. Cover.
Okay.
I would prefer not to be handcuffed.
And I would prefer not to be a guard in a small town making minimum wage and trying to arrest shitbags. But guess what? We gotta do what we gotta do.
Why don't you become an adventurer?
Well, one, took an arrow to the knee. Two.
I'm sorry you hear Chloe say, I'm sorry to hear about that. Did you get it properly healed?
No, there was no healers around at the time. Also, I was doing a lot of drugs.
Oh.
It was a bad time in my life. And this is about to be a bad time in your life. Cuff him.
How about this? Instead of cuffing me, I will come willingly. I'm not, trust me, unlike my comrade here, I don't, run from something I did not do, or whatever you think I did.
Well, you can try to convince him with a persuasion, but currently
that I didn't do it, or wasn't involved in it?
You can do both of those. I was talking about on him not cuffing you, because currently he is pretty set on cuffing you.
I would prefer not to be cuffed. Okay, let's do this.
Alright, that's a pretty high roll right there for persuasion. So you'd be like, alright, as long as you keep your nose clean, you just walk behind. But you, with the weird blue-purple skin, raisin. Put on the cuffs!
What's a raisin?
I don't know, but put on the cuffs.
Can I not say I did?
No.
Please?
Well, no.
I mean,
I asked nicely, please, a cherry on top.
Oh, and I responded nicely. No. Yeah. With the cherry on bottom.
I mean, frankly,
what kind of monster puts the cherry on bottom?
Put on their cuffs!
In which Chloe says, well,
put
he did call-
cuffs on your testicles!
Because I already have some, thank you. Ow!
In which Chloe says, well, he did call me 10 years old!
Are you sleeping with a minor, you fucking monster?
Actually, I'm not that young.
Ew! No, never, not with a halfling.
Cuff him, boys! Can you stop saying that, boys? You said that like 8 times. Well, you still haven't cuffed him. That's when we don't actually have handcuffs.
Where's my alchemist fire when I need it?
I think you know.
Did he say that in character, or Chloe just?
I don't know. I at this point, I just want to make whatever I want to make you guys say in character. So this is like anytime you say anything, I just randomly decide if it's in character. Basically, if it's in character for your character, I make it go. That sounded like it was in character for his character.
Which Chloe gives him a look like, really?
They're gonna be like, Alchemist Fire? That shit's dangerous. It just burned a town down a couple of days ago.
Wait, what?
I have no memory of that.
Wait, what did the guard say?
He's like, alchemist fire is dangerous. It just burned a whole town down a couple days ago.
Oh,
such an unfortunate accident.
Yeah, they say it was some douchebag.
I mean, I'm gonna burn down an entire town. You have to be a douchebag, right?
Right? Anyway, we're gonna take you in. We're gonna make sure that you don't have any wanted posters so that we can see if we make some money. And if you didn't
do
anything.
I had a problem like this in the last town. They tried accusing me of burning down the fire just because I had the same body style as the person on the wanted poster.
You know, that's usually how wanted posters work. You know, if you look like the guy on it, you know, then you get wanted. How the poster works.
Didn't you just
But that's racist.
I don't think that's racist. I think that's how a wanted poster works. If I put a wanted poster of that yellow thing, would that be racist? If I put a wanted poster of that halfling over there, would that be racist?
I mean, how many halflings are there in the world?
I don't know. Fucking dirty halflings. And
she just gives a look like, what did I do? I mean, I'm coming along peacefully. You don't need to handcuff me. And
you keep quiet and keep your unhandcuffed mouth shut.
Okay.
Also, thank you for the suggestion.
What suggestion was that?
To shut the You! In the purple, put on the cuffs or die. Or fight. Yeah. Or run. Those are also technically options, but I really only want the first two. So those are the ones I'm presenting you. Fight or die. But wait, no. Or put on the handcuffs. Or die.
So there's just three options.
Technically, there's a fourth if I want to pull it off.
Is it die? Because I think you need that one.
No, this is a fourth option. Possible fourth option.
I love that. It's like, there's a fourth option. Possible fourth option. Wait. Alright.
I mean, it's all really up to Axel.
He's the female. Oh no, she rolled for the year. So, give me a moment. Alright, yep. So now it's gonna go, But man, it cannot hit you. You guys have armor classes. Also, the mimic just doesn't get good rolls, but it tries to bite you again.
No,
and this guy, having seen it eat another person, is just gonna run away.
Wait, I said those two, that meaning both, and I got him.
You gotta do two rolls for that, it's two separate actions.
Well, let me roll.
I sent you a message, Axel.
Oh, damn, alright. Oh. Alright, well, it does eat that person, but then when you try to get it to follow you, it also tries to bite you. Alright,
no,
two.
Add mimic. You already had two people.
Oh lord, so many messages.
Actually, sorry, bad
nibbler. Yep, because it's strong. Yep.
No nibbler.
Yep, that is that. Why is that one not showing? Oh, that's weird. Anyway. Also, roll, keep forgetting that. Really should just put it back on the timer. I think you forget about that a lot too, don't you?
Uh-huh.
From the last time, do you even know what you were the time before?
What is that again for me?
If I'm not correct, it's LG.
Shit, it is.
So, not only is he has to follow those rules.
Oh, man.
I hate this shit.
You're the one who was just trying to cop out again. This is how you got yourself in this situation in the first place, is trying to take the easy way out. But no. I don't read the fine print. I don't care. Alright, let's do the D100 roll, see what it has to say.
Meantime, just Chloe's just quietly.
Alright, a lightning bolt strikes the ground between you and Gnomebeard, and the cupcake appears.
And then Chloe kind of peers over, like, to see what the what was that, all that in hullabaloo for. And she just looks at it, and looks at the cupcake, and says, "Really? A cupcake?
What the fuck is that cupcake about? What the hell? You in the purple, what the f-?"
And she kind of looks at the, walks up, looks at the, probably grabs the cupcake. It's just like, "You know, I would say this is a good treat for me, but I don't want to eat it."
It is a clear message from my goddess. She is willing to throw cupcakes down at you if you let me go free.
I'm on a diet.
And Chloe just looks at him like, "Really?"
Also, I messaged you. Jewel.
Of course I do.
Just needed you to know.
Yeah.
Also, because you still technically should have that other thing active, I think.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. She looks at it, she's just like, "I wouldn't eat this cupcake, though."
The cop's gonna go, "Why not?"
It rubs me the bad way. You're going to, it rubs me the bad way. Like, it rubs the palate in a bad way. That is generally a sign you don't eat that cupcake.
The guard's going to look at you and then spitefully pick up the cupcake and eat it.
Okay, and when I say I warned you, don't say nothing else and do not have me arrested. Because I warned as the paladin. With a bunch of misfits. I question my life choices here and there. But this one's definitely that one.
And so the guard is eating the cupcake when Donnie comes up and basically like jumps and kicks him in the face.
And which Chloe just looks at that and just says, "You know, I would say what I'm thinking, but you kindly asked me to cut down on the chatter."
And then Donnie runs off, having ruined that cupcake. "Fucking Donnie!" You hear the guard say as he spits out pieces of teeth and cupcake.
I don't think that would be a coincidence, right?
Yeah.
I mean,
he's gonna look back at him and say, "Alright, unless you can produce said mimic before us now, as well as the missing people and 500 gold, we're all going to jail, where you will be interrogated and most likely summarily executed or sold for slavery."
Chloe kind of raises her hand. Like kid, and says, "Well, what about why am I held accountable for these guys?"
Well, you're with them, guilt by association.
Yeah, but I'm stuck with them kind of because they kind of owe me a favor, Tan.
Man, it sounds like that favor was not worth it.
Yeah, I know it isn't. Chloe says, "Yeah, it's not worth it, but also, debts have to be paid. You know how that is."
At which point, the Abra shows back up.
Chloe looks at the Abra, the yellow thing. She's just like, "Plus, the only thing I think we can bring, you know, that would probably be a reputable witness is this, this thing." In which she kind of points to the Abra. Like, well, there's this.
What the hell is that?
this thing that it teleported us here.
I give the Abra a bow, a shrug, a nod, and then another bow.
The Abra looks very confused.
And golly, just kind
basically,
of
you just looked at the Abra and went gobble gobble block block. But in gobble gobble block block. Or one of those, just one of the fucking ones, you wouldn't like me when I'm hungry.
Chloe is like, you know, I mean, truly, am I guilty by just sadly just owing them a favor, they owe me a favor?
I mean, that's guilty pretty much what guilt by association means, yes. That's what a wanted poster does, yes.
Yes, I understand how a wanted poster works, but also at the same rate, I'm not the guilty one that just had it. Really, put a cupcake in front of you, and ironically, you picked it up and, you know, ate it.
Well, that was Fred. Fred's an idiot. Isn't that right, Fred? What? Yeah, that's right, Fred.
Yeah, see? And I'm not the guilty party here. I warned people.
Well, you should have warned yourself not to hang out with people who feed people to mimics.
Well, do you want to pick a fight with a whole miniature group of adventurers and kind of not end up pleasant? In a pleasant situation.
He looks around. You know what? You're right. Let's get out of here, boys. This is not worth the time. Treebeard! Talk to the Count Council. We'll see you next meeting. What the fuck? Get back here! You get paid to do this! Yeah, we don't get paid that much. Look at them! They got a fucking mimic, too? You're full of shit. Fuck you, Gnomebeard.
Wait, what did I miss?
I don't know how I talk my way out of that.
I'm going to get you off of this. To be fair, and this is something that people don't always think, and I try not to, like, reveal often, but, like, in small towns, you guys are most likely the strongest people around. Like, there's not going to be any, like, level 10 adventurers just sitting in some small town unless I'm like, oh, the bartender is a badass or a former adventurer, which is fun to do sometimes, right? When I did it with the alchemist, it was funny. Or the blacksmith, it's funny. It wouldn't have been as funny to do that again here with Treebeard and a bunch of veterans and make you do what I want. Now, having said that, that doesn't mean you've been let off the hook by any means. Don't forget, you've been seen and identified for these crimes, basically. You've not been excused for them or anything. And in much in the same way that you were identified and not excused when you were in the last town and had consequences, so, like, you couldn't go back in for just willy-nilly. Even leaving was really just, you know, me letting you guys leave as opposed to getting shit on by the walls. Because the guards would never have let you pass.
Yeah, if I didn't roll persuasion to let our behinds go through.
Basically.
Which, Chloe's just sitting there just like, I don't know how the heck does that actually work, but seriously, we don't talk about this. This is getting chalked up if we don't talk about this, right?
Doris is like, has anyone seen Donnie?
Donnie just kicked one of the guards.
Oh, yeah, he's a real scamp. But seriously, yeah, where'd he go?
I don't know.
If he doesn't get his medication every 2 hours... It's a little quack.
And she just looks at him like, really? I couldn't figure when he kicked the guard in the face enough that he...
Can't hear you, gotta find Donnie! Donnie! And then he's in the
and
pond.
Looks at the at the yellow thing. You know, you teleport to random places. Do you, any chance you teleport to teleport a single person away from chaos?
It shrugs.
Of course. Of course it does. Of course, that shrug. Alright.
I love the mechanics on this fucking side characters, because they're all so well made for what they are. It's like,
yeah.
Oh, you have a character that's basically a deus ex machina? Yeah, he doesn't do anything useful. And he knows he's not useful, and he doesn't care.
And which Chloe's just like, oh, alright, okay. And probably we're royally screwed down the line. Because that borrower is going to have some problems on his hands, because he does not have an employees.
He'll find more.
In a small town.
Yeah, as soon as you get rid of this fog and whatnot, bust back.
So what ended up happening to the employees?
You just hear, just see Chloe just face palms, like, she's just questioning herself a little bit as she's feeling the exhaustion, like, a little bit. She's just, like, sitting down on the ground.
Oh, speaking of, make a roll for constitution and wisdom. Both Dfrnt and Jewel.
God damn it.
Ooh.
Yeah, that's 6. Before the card. And a 6. Boy. I don't know what I'm gonna be forgetting
now, potato.
Were you rolling with disadvantage on those?
Yes, because any ability checks.
Ability checks, not saving throws.
Oh.
Yeah, so I thought that was weird too, but I checked when I was looking through it. If you look on the little one it posted, it has the one is disadvantage on ability checks, and level 3 exhaustion is disadvantage on attack rolls and saving throws. So that's why it's apparently separate.
Okay.
I don't know. But
okay,
yeah, so you can take the first roll from each of those. So that would be 21 and 15, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fine. Dfrnt, on the other hand, you don't get any levels of exhaustion, but
Oh God.
Oh yeah, trust me.
I don't like this adventure anymore.
Really? Which you can almost hear out of character. Really?
These towns are shit.
I mean,
most of the time, the towns you go to are as an adventuring party. I mean, you go somewhere, there's a monster or a fucking dungeon. It's never nice. It's never like a vacation.
It's not like the first one where there's weird fucking magic shit happening at random. Like this one where it's covered in a dense fog that's fucking people's brains.
I feel like the second one is pretty typical.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, Lord. Ah! The mimic is looking for more food. It's smelling the horse that it already ate.
Follows the mimic.
You know, right now, let's find the reason why this fog is crazy like this.
You just hear quack, and Donnie steps out from the bar.
Anyway, she's just like, we don't understand what you're saying without a translator. You know that, right?
Quack. Donnie, if you found the source of this mysterious fog, could you lead us to it?
Yeah.
Thars runs back. Oh, there you are, Donnie. Quack. Donnie says you guys are lazy as fuck.
Okay,
we had some unexpected issues.
Unexpected is an understatement.
Donnie says that this is gonna be a lot harder now.
Yeah, I figured it would be.
Of course.
Quack. Oh, also Donnie said. Wait, Donnie. Donnie, I can't say that. Quack. Donnie, I'm not black like you.
Oh, God. Chloe's just like, you know what? Did you find the source?
Quack. Donnie says that he's still kind of not sure, but we might be able to go talk to this one guy. Apparently his name's Gnomebeard?
Oh, oh. Shit.
Oh, really? The barkeeper to this bar, and she thumbs over to the bar behind her that says the Manticore's Pit. Yeah, and these guys did a fantastic job with that.
Quack. Donnie says, what have you done to jeopardize the integrity of the mission? The entire livelihood of the town and even your own lives could be compromised at this point. Even those of mystical origins will soon fall under effect of this heavy fog. I think. Translation's pretty rough. Might have been talking about donuts.
Yeah. How about you ask these two, but if not, let me just shorten it. That one with the mimic. Fed it the staff here. And she kind of thumbs back to the manticore. And this guy is the ringleader included. Because he's sick, total.
And the mimic are not even near you anymore, so.
I know. She's just like.
Quack. Donnie said that the mimic and the girl are gone.
Yeah. But they come back, and which that's bad. And the guards were trying to arrest us, and I think I maybe talked too much. And
the
maybe.
Donnie sighs.
Yeah, I know that feeling. And I probably.
I feel like you and Donnie both do the same sigh.
Yeah.
Alright, Donnie, take us to Gnomebeard.
Quack. Yeah. Donnie says that's probably a bad idea now.
You know, I hate to be that person that wouldn't leave people out to dry, normally. But why don't we just throw him and Sam in there first, and then walk in? Then walk in after he's gotten his chilled out a little bit.
I ain't getting thrown anywhere. Walks off.
Boy, I was joking. I was honestly a little bit of joking. That was for the 10-year-old comment. Honestly, that was for the 10-year-old comment again.
I'm in the darkness.
The Abra is going to look around, and he's just gonna sigh.
And with
also, Cuerin, in his rush through the fog, ran directly into a building. Face first.
Yeah! Tink!
Chloe is just...
Falls over on the ground.
Yeah, see what I'm working with here, Donnie?
Quack. Donnie Fancy. Says that despite our difficulties, there may still be an answer at hand. We need to go to the local underground.
Oh.
The underground? It's not run by Bartholomew Benjamin, is it?
Quack. No, Donnie says he hates that guy, though.
Oh, okay.
Quack. He says it's because he's a dog.
Oh, yeah, I remember that blink dog fiasco.
Quack. Donnie says he was not originally a dog, which is why he's a poser.
Yeah.
I like it.
Yeah. And Chloe's just Quack. Like, yeah, he was a little kid. I don't know, the details are fuzzy, but I remember, you know, dealing with that guy.
Quack. Donnie says to follow him to the underground.
And do some high-speed racing, too.
Quack,
chocobos?
Donnie says that they only do chocobo racing on Thursdays.
Damn.
All Thursdays have been outlawed in this town.
And Chloe's just like, if it's any consolation, you know, there's a running guy joke of I call them Lily.
Quack. Donnie says that's hilarious.
Yeah, see, that's even more better humor. You hate the. That's gonna be something to be funny to laugh at a little bit.
Quack. Donnie says it's right here. It's this building. Right in front of us.
So does anyone want to check for a door, or do you guys really want to see what comes bum rushing us?
Quack. Donnie says he knows.
I want to bust through the wall like a Kool-Aid man.
Quack. Donnie says that he knows where the door is, but he cannot open it as he has no hands.
Yeah. Show me the door. I can open it.
Donnie like pecks on the wall, right there.
Oh. You know. Find the hand for the door where Donnie pecked.
You don't see one right away with your passive perception.
Okay.
Make your roll again. Hey, look. Literally the best outcome except for another one.
And she's just like, I'm having a little bit.
That is pretty much as good as I can hope for. hey, and it was like, quack. Donnie's like, do you really, he's like, you have hands and you still can't open the door.
Is it like a secret passage?
Quack. Donnie says, yeah.
Ah. It's not that I'm stupid. It's just that it's a little bit difficult when I'm short side.
Quack. Donnie says, what's his excuse?
I don't know. No, I can't.
I'm just stupid!
Quack.
Oh, hey, what are you guys doing here?
Trying to find the door.
Yeah.
Quack. Donnie says, oh no, the despoiler of plans. The ruiner of bars. She has arrived once again with her minion to destroy all that is holy.
What are you talking about?
That or he said hi, I can't tell.
I don't get it. What are you talking about?
I mean, both are wrong, Donnie. And she, and Chloe says.
The Abra sits on the mimic.
No, bad thing. Go off of the mimic.
And it disappears again with the mimic.
No, Nibbler! Runs off to look for Nibbler.
I love that it just disappears, so she just runs in a random direction.
Spear, no, come back!
We just found you again, for the first time.
Let me try this again. Jeez.
I rolled a 14 for my third perception check.
That one is still not quite there, unfortunately.
God damn it!
The secret door.
Stupid yellow jerk.
You can roll with advantage, though, since you know it's there and have been instructed as to where it's at.
Maybe I'll eventually get this.
That's a 2. My bad.
Alright, there you go, Michael.
Yay!
That would be a 10.
You were so close before.
Where the hell is my mimic?
Quack. Okay. Donnie says that mysterious teleporting creature has taken it to a land beyond time and space for unknown reasons.
You to hear that.
In which, Chloe looks at Donnie and is just like, maybe it's for the best. Because, we don't want it to eat anymore, whatever is to that door.
What are you talking about? What does the mimic have to do with you?
Okay. It ate people. People that are probably in there.
It's a mimic. What do you expect it to eat?
love the idea
what
of
do
making
you expect
that.
It to eat? Oh, Samira.
And she's like, never mind, I'll leave it to you. And she kind of walks through.
Shrugs, continues to look for her mimic.
Okay, and she kind of peeks in through the door. But holds the door for Donnie, kind of like, yeah, I'm guessing you're gonna want to go in too, right?
Quack.
Quack. Donnie says he's not allowed in there anymore.
Oh. Is Catharis allowed
Quack.
To go in there?
Donnie says he is, but Donnie doesn't let. Wait, what do you mean I'm not allowed to go in, Donnie?
God, Axel, I love your character so much.
Thank yeah, I know, right?
I just try to play them as naturally to their original character design as possible. It's not my fault they were designed ridiculously. Wait, yes it is.
And Chloe's like, well, wait a minute. So neither of you, so I'm guessing you guys are going to stand out here and keep an eye on her if she doesn't beat anyone else to a mimic.
Quack. Samira, Donnie says that he's not doing anything to stop that mimic.
Why
Quack.
Do I have to go in there?
Because it'll eventually get your mimic back, maybe?
What?
I don't know if that's... I feel like that should be under deception.
Yeah. So I said maybe.
I still feel like you're trying to use your words to deceive her, though.
I was just yelling at the air.
If we made her use the misdirection one earlier
to
get fucked over, we gotta make you do it too.
16.
You gotta counter that roll, Dfrnt.
What do I counter it with?
Insight, yeah. I don't know why we
And it would
I
be at a disadvantage if she took a level of exhaustion.
Oh, that's right.
I took something else.
Oh no, yeah, she took the memory. She didn't take a level of exhaustion.
Oh,
oh and she crit rolled. She knows you're lying. She knows you're full of shit.
And in the meantime, Chloe is going to leave those two.
Whatever.
Whatever.
And that yells lies to me. Great.
And Chloe walks in and is just like, okay.
Yells again at the air. Bring Nibbler back, you jerk.
He's like, I'll just be out here watching her yell it at the sky. Quack. Shut the hell up, Johnny.
That's when the yellow monster brings back an actual fucking Nibbler.
Now that would be the bee's knees, but then you would probably all be dead. Let's not forget that Nibbler probably eats even more than this fucking mimic does.
Yeah. I mean, I watched Nibbler swallow what was it, whole? Something that's like 20 to 50 times its size?
Oh, easily, yeah. Let's not forget that it's not even, like I said, just about what it can swallow, it's the fact of how much it actually eats. In essence, it ate the last of every species on its own planet.
Let's not do that.
I like the party a lot.
It wasn't its home planet, technically.
True. It was what was left of its little planet. It was just a small
planet. So,
anyway.
Yeah, let's not do that. We have enough issues, I think.
Yeah, and Chloe's just gonna, you know, kindly walk in. To see if she... What is this?
I guess you might have to make a perception check. Ta-da.
Rolls a double one.
I'm waiting for it. That's really all. Once that happens, I will kill the whole party. That is what will happen with the double one. That is what the double critical is for. I'll reserve that from an act of God where you just get...
A 7.
You see, it is a large, monstrous creature with wings and a tail and 3 heads.
Okay, what are you, if I may ask?
You just get indiscriminate roaring and hissing noises. Well, hello, who is it that's come through the door today?
were told that you could possibly help us.
And who told you this? Answer carefully.
I'll answer truthfully.
It's not what I said, but okay. That's not what I said, but okay.
It was a duck.
Why the fuck would I take the word of a duck and help you?
Because it was Donnie?
Oh, Donnie, okay. Yeah, you're good. He's not coming in here, right?
No.
No. He told us that he wasn't allowed.
He's not. He broke everything last time.
I can believe that. Well, anyway, what is this? And she kind of points to the...
Oh, that's Galen. My pet Chimera.
Ah.
Slash Enforcer.
Okay.
Isn't that right, Galen?
Oh, just like nice to meet you.
Yeah, the goat side just fucks, but the other two are good.
Yeah, that sounds accurate. Definitely interesting to see one.
Right, thank you. So, what brings you here besides the advice of Donnie Darko?
We are here to see if we can try to solve the fog problem you're having. Like, it's magical fog, and it's not good in the sense of
what fog? Oh wait, yes, you mean the fog of forgetfulness.
Yeah, and it's very draining.
Yes, it also makes you quite tired. It's because it comes from the well of weakness, you see.
The well of weakness.
Yes.
That's where it originates from.
Yes. It's a phenomenon.
By the way, where would we find the well of weakness?
Well, you would find the well somewhere evil. Somewhere drained of life. It is...
Alright, that's enough about me, and now we need the location of the well.
Okay, yes, your mother... No, sorry,
Chloe kind of starts snickering, smoking like snorts.
Apologies, I get very forgetful in this storm, and, to be truthful, we don't know. We just know that it is underground somewhere. It seeps up through cracks in the ground around the city for miles in each direction. You're lucky to have even made it into the center of town. Most people get lost and die before they ever get here.
This fog doesn't seem to affect me.
Oh, that's good. I'd be careful, though. That might not last long. The fog, it searches. It pries for your weakness. For that which makes you forget.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely draining.
Yeah, also, I'm pretty sure there's some drugs in this shit.
I wouldn't be surprised. I mean, we've been to a town where the magic was so strong it swapped people with animals.
Ah, yes, Ozma. No one ever goes there if they're smart.
Yeah, no, neither did we go there for the sightseeing. It was just we were passing through the town.
Ah, yes. Ozma is a pass-through town.
Yeah, it's very weird.
Or it was, before some jackass burnt it to the ground last week.
Chloe is just gonna
What's
be like,
so
yeah,
funny?
That sounds very tragic.
It was. 200 lives lost to the fire. Also some kids.
That's sad.
Yeah. But they were orphans, so no one loved them anyway.
And when she was like, I would've.
Well, it's too bad you didn't. They're dead now, no one loves them.
I mean, jeez.
Too much, I apologize.
Wow. Oh no, I know.
Even Dfrnt's just like, wow.
laughing. It was.
Yeah, no. Out of character, I'm laughing my behind off. In character, Chloe's just like, I don't care.
I sent you a message, Axel.
Oh lord.
I just see Bender when he was with all the those kids.
Anyway, if it seems from underground, do you think you know where underground other than probably, or have an idea, mildly, like an entry point?
Well,
farther underground.
There may be. There used to be a cavern entrance not far from here, if I remember correctly.
Huh.
But? I don't remember anymore. I need someone to lift the curse on me. To lift the fog's effects on me if I am to help them find the spot.
Oh, and our mage isn't with us.
And this is not classified as a disease, is it?
Nope.
Or a poison affecting a creature?
Nope. It's a curse. It's a curse.
Which is funny, because you should still have that, but only third level, I think, or something. I don't remember. Or you might not have picked it. I love it, because you have no idea if this is your mimic.
I was about to say, like,
did you ever put that cape on it?
I was looking for... There's, like, nothing in this town.
Yeah, this town does kind of suck right now.
I guess I'll do a perception check to see if it's nimbler.
Go for it. It looks like your one. It's still covered in blood. Seems pretty happy and hungry.
How about we find something to show it that you are you? And we could also look for snacks. Come on.
Feed it the yellow monster.
And you can just hear in the background a Chloe that is like, no, not him. He actually got us hopeful.
Looking for something.
Okay.
I'll go into this bar again. Because that's already inside.
Okay.
Because I'll roll a perception check to see if I find anything. 13.
Unfortunately, aside from the blood on the floor, it looks like you've cleared out the body parts from earlier.
So, we should probably find you something red. So it doesn't look like it's always stained.
Anyway. Yeah, it says, if not, you can possibly search for a large fog opening in the ground. It would be foggier than all the other places. Perhaps if you can find magic, if you looked for the most dense areas of magic in the area, you could find the source. At least that's what my chimera says.
Will something like detect magic do the job?
I suppose it could. If used properly with your perception.
Yeah. I would need some time to rest and not, you know. Because I'm already a little drained from the fog. It's always happening the day I get caught by it.
Excuse me. Sorry about that. Bleh. He says, well, if you need to rest, good luck with that. I hear that sometimes the barkeep likes to let people rent the stable. He's a great guy.
Yes. Just
can we just, like, sleep on the floor here?
I would not suggest it. The Chimera sleeps here. He's not fond of sharing.
Can I, like, sleep over here in this corner?
I mean, the Chimera still fits over there, but if you choose to, I'm not going to stop you. I'm also not going to pick up the bones in the morning.
let's see. Actually, I'm curious. Isn't your Chimera? Seems very smart. And probably has wings, correct?
Yes.
Wouldn't it be able to fly up and be able to see, you know, where the largest condense of it is?
He doesn't see magic.
Well, what if someone sat on his back and as he flew? And
well, I guess this could be possible, but it wouldn't be cheap. That's for sure.
Of course it wouldn't be, but if also if we solve this problem, it's a win-win situation. I would think.
Well, I guess it's interesting. Weird. There's something wrong. So I guess chimeras can't fly and don't have wings in D&D 5e.
What?
Yeah. Chimeras? No, those are manticores.
Same. Oh.
That's a role for.
Only in D&D, though. In regular mythology, chimeras have the wings of an eagle, too.
Yeah, see. That's what I was thinking about, too. I remembered.
Wings of a dragon as well.
Yeah, and they do have. Wait a minute, chimeras do have wing flight.
Just not in D&D 5e.
Yes, they do.
I think so.
Yeah, they have a speed of 30 and a flight of 60.
Oh yeah, it does. It's so weird. Why does it have a different on this site? Oh no, it does. It's just a different layout. That is so weird.
Yeah, I thought so. I thought chimeras do.
I was like, even the picture I looked up earlier, which is why I had fucking put it on, I was like, alright, cool, it's a flying thing, so they can't just run away from it if they want to be dicks. It's got a dragon head. Suck it, Michael! Now who flies?
Don't look at me.
Not me!
That's also true. Speaking of, the Chimera grabs you, flies you 80 feet in the air, and drops you.
Me? I can't see magic.
That's why it dropped you.
Oh, that's kind of nice.
Anyway, Chloe's. Well, it was me that has the idea. But don't grab it by your mouth, please.
He's like, all right. Well, how much are you willing to pay me to ride my Chimera?
Do we get a discount since we're trying to solve the problem?
I guess so. I mean, I don't really give a shit about this town, but I do live here, so.
Yeah.
750 gold.
Done. Sold.
Alright, I heard the price. Pay up, Chloe.
And she looks at the Veilios. I am not paying that much for that. And plus, are you really gonna take his, take him, if he's not my dealer? And plus, he does poor life decisions, trust me.
The Chimera just looks at you and roars.
How about this, we make it 500 silver pieces and we don't, and you don't have to save me alive?
Well, I suppose so. I mean, it's not like he's doing anything, lazy bastard. Manticore looks back angrily.
Well, you guys are a bunch of sweethearts. You're letting me do this. Looking would totally pet it, but just not gonna risk losing a hand for it.
It's a good decision.
Oh, you got half in luck. You can do it.
No. So she pays up 500. Gives him 500
silver pieces.
Here you go, 500 silver pieces. She kind of walks over to him, just like, kind of does that, just offers it to him. Here you go. Now, how is this gonna work, by the way?
Well, there's a root patch.
I know, but how am I going to be on Manticore?
You hop on the back, take hold of a snake, and don't squeeze too tight or it'll bite.
Of course.
I'm guessing this is either... Okay, what do they have for skills on this one? Because I know they took out riding, right?
It would just be animal handling.
I guess so. Because animal handling is for... calming down, keep a mount from being spooked, or intuit a animal's intentions.
And would she kind of...
And you can make an animal handling check to control your mount when you attempt a risky maneuver. This is why I missed 3.5. It was just so much more specific.
And Chloe kind of puts her backpack down and kind of hands it to Veilios and says, "You keep an eye on this." Because I don't think my full-on weight would do him any good.
Like, who is this that just walked the fuck in?
That's one of our fellow traveling members.
In which Chloe does not look away and says, "Also, keep an eye on Samara, for goodness sakes. Kindly."
The Chimera looks at the mimic. Intently.
Of course he does. And she's just like, "Oh, I'm gonna kindly
get off. Why the would you bring a mimic in here? Those aren't pets."
I would.
Now this is a pet, and he points at the fucking Chimera.
And Chloe is like, "I will not get between the two of you in that. You two have that pet one-up competition. Well, we go see how much where this fog is at."
Well, you're gonna have to wait. I can't have a pet one-up competition if my pet's not here.
Okay.
All right, you.
Wait. Oh no. Oh no.
My pet is the best.
Why are you hating on Nibbler?
Well, one. Why you brought a mimic into my shop?
You have a thing.
Because it's my shop.
Can we have this one up after, you know, I...
No!
Okay, then. And I'm guessing no way heck I can try to persuade him.
Why can't Nibbler be in here?
Why are you in here?
I was told to come in earlier, I just didn't.
By who?
By me, she's one of our companions that's traveling with us.
The fuck she have a mimic for?
Sandwich Chloe in the corner.
It's a long story.
It's a very long
story. I don't have time for this.
Companions.
Just get the fuck out of here. Go! Get you and your filthy monster out. Only my filthy monster gets to stay. And then he has to go too in the sky.
Oh my god.
Guard!
Sorry, Mirror, please, could you just go get just leave?
Gotta escort these two out of here.
Please.
Rumbles. Fine.
Hey.
Nibbler hates your store anyway.
And Veilios is sitting there just questioning your life decisions.
What is wrong with you people?
I mean, do you want me to argue with that woman? I mean, I could probably win the argument.
Get on the fucking chimera.
Yeah, okay. Not arguing. If she just kindly...
If you hurt even a single scale on Lalandra's head...
Trust me, no, I wouldn't try that.
Okay. Lalandra, you be a good chimera. Only eat people if you want to. Be back before I need you, because I don't trust these motherfuckers.
And Chloe's like, well, I'm not that bad. I'm a half. I'm not that much of a prick.
All right, take your trip to find out your information on the. Why were you even here again?
We're borrowing your chimera.
For
it's gonna fly up above the fog. The paladin is going to use detect magic to figure out the dense source of the fog is coming from, and then we're going to lift the fog.
Exactly.
Alrighty. That doesn't sound familiar to me. Whatever the fuck you say. Now everybody but Michael, make a fortitude and wisdom check. Or constitution wisdom check, sorry. I'm never gonna get used to that. Very nice. Oof. That's not good.
Yeah, that is not good. And I'm worried now.
That is actually another set of effects. Which is... Speed halved. Oof. And we're right about at that time, too, where it's coming towards the end. But that's okay, because once we finish off this interaction with the chimera, I think it'll be a good stop point.
Mm-hmm.
Oof. Double oof. Double oof. Oof.
In the meantime, yep. Please go to your button. Try to get on the chimera.
Okay.
In which is a This is gonna be funny. In the meantime, she's on this or try to get to the, you know, pulls her up behind up over there.
Alrighty. The chimera is lowers itself so that you can get on.
Yeah, she just finally says thank you. And kind of gently pats it, you know how you would pet a cat on its behind its ear, but
okay.
Put a lion head.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
It seems pretty happy with that. Well, the head that you did do that to.
Yeah. She's just like, I'm sorry, I don't know how you guys would appreciate it. To the other two, like, she's just... And just tries to make herself at least a little bit comfortable, but not too comfortable that they're inconvenienced.
Gotcha.
And she's just lightly taps like, I'm ready to go.
Alright, and the person's like, yep.
Really?
Look, I don't make
the... Really? This is Appa, right?
I don't make the choices, and you fly into the sky, into the center of the goddamn fog.
Yeah.
And so now you're able to see... I mean, you really aren't able to see jack shit. You're just able to see fog in every direction.
But does she... Okay.
Bam! I'm gonna have to start limiting you on your time so you can't just make 30 rolls until you get a crit, Dfrnt. That's not how check rolls work.
Well, who knows how long she's been waiting at this
point. but if you're bad at searching for something, that doesn't change the 30th time you search.
Thank gosh, I nat one. I crit failed.
You get to go back up to him. Well, I still don't think I don't think you have disadvantage until you're level 3 exhaustion.
But it's an ability check, correct?
Oh, that is an ability check. Yep. Damn. Anyway.
But I crit failed and rerolled.
Yes, you did. You lucky, unlucky person. Like, that's so probably the only class I should ever take is fucking halfling at this point. With all the crit fails. Alright, almost time for bed. A sped of time, fair. So Dfrnt, you were able to find a red blanket hanging on a clothesline somewhere. And it has, like, a little clip on it. Yay. Were able to see that up in the sky there is tons and tons of fog, but it seems like a high concentration of if it is coming from a few miles north of the town.
Okay.
No, not into the trees.
Yeah, back into the
miles
trees.
Miles north. Which she definitely remembers that. Make sure to remember that.
It works.
There's not much else to say. It's like, tries to put on mimic. Yes.
And she's just like, yeah, I got it, okay.
And the chimera looks up at you with one of its heads, the dragon head, let's say, or the goat head.
Okay.
We'll say the goat
head.
He basically does look like Nibbler now because I put a on him earlier, torn up.
He's just like, okay, I see it. I think I see it. Okay, so up north.
And then Chloe flew away on the chimera, never to be seen again.
I was waiting for it.
This is just abandoning the entire party, saying, fuck these guys, I'm out, while Donnie Ducko quacks in the distance.
Yeah, hopefully he grabbed my stuff, got Catharus to get it, and just book it.
But yes, after... So after having done that, you're able to see it's north, and the chimera comes down after a few minutes, as it is trained to do.
Yeah, and then she kind of, again, gives the lionhead somewhat of a, you know, cat scratch. As well as one to the other two. And which those are a little bit longer since she didn't do it for the initial. Well, thank you.
And he says, you're welcome. Thank you for the money.
Yes. It's not too bad. I mean, it's towards the cause, right? I mean, especially if we fix the fog. It does
yeah,
look good.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. I don't have a lot of faith in you, but good luck.
Thank you for at least tossing a coin towards it.
Toss the coin to your witcher, O Valley of Chimeras.
Right.
God.
And she kind of slides off of the chimera's back and just again, grabs her backpack, make sure everything is set there.
And I think that is pretty much it. The next step will be going to find the source of the fog.
Yeah, and when she checks her stuff.
What, you think I'm gonna steal something?
And she kind of looks at Veilios like, I wouldn't put it past you.
What they don't know is he's already secretly stolen everything.
You are classist.
Not wrong, but that doesn't
just
mean
because
I'm
a rogue, assuming I'm going to steal stuff.
He says as he is lifting your wallet.
I know, right? That's why she's giving him a look.
Perfect,
oh, really?
I feel like the actual perfect rogue, though, description is probably fucking Tasselhoff from the Dragonlance Tales. He is the perfect description of what a rogue really is.
Never read it, so I wouldn't know.
It is a great, like, it's hard to describe, but they're... It's a weird mix of a character, but he's definitely the rogue character, and he's... His thieving is the best part, and his essential races is just like, oh, well, I found this on the ground, and I didn't know who it belonged to, so I figured I should just keep it for safekeeping so it didn't get stepped on. And that's it. That's how he, that's why and how he steals. It just follows that logic the whole time.
Nice.
So he never actually steals anything. He's just like, oh, yeah, I found this, or it somehow ended up in my pocket.
Truck.
Who would have known? Oh, I thought you looked. It looked dangerous out there, so I grabbed it from your. Like, even if he does steal it, he's like, "No, I was just protecting it." Like, and he believes it. It's too good.
And which, yeah, Chloe does, you know, relay the information, and definitely if we get a map or so.
We don't need a map. A few miles to the north, we got this.
We would have to navigate our way.
I mean, you'd have to do that even with a map.
Yeah, true.
Map is pointless.
Says the guy that... Says you, dear sir.
Now then,
anyway.
If you don't have any more business, I'll have to ask you to leave. It's time to feed the griffin.
Chimera.
No. I have a griffin as well.
Out of curiosity, do you have any, like, baby chimeras or baby... Griffins for sale?
No.
Damn it.
They keep eating the babies.
Oh, hi.
Night, Dfrnt.
Well,
thanks for playing with us.
Yes, good night.
Okay. Well, Chloe's like, well, do you have any pets for sale?
Nope, it has to be a griffin or a chimera. Next time they have a baby, try to save one.
I tried last time. I lost a finger.
Oh, that's horrible.
Also, we would have had other pets, but the auction we get them from burned down the other week.
Oh, of course.
We were going to get some excellent flail snails.
Oh, my flail snails are so big. Seen them before. That's why I said that.
Yes, I like them as well. Well, if that's all, I must go feed the griffin, and then kill this chimera.
Anyway, if you do get some pets in, interesting ones, maybe from another seller or buyer or whatever.
Well, I got this yellow thing, but it keeps disappearing on me.
Is it a yellow thing that...
Motherfucker, he's back!
Yes, that guy! He's how we got into the town safely!
You son of a bitch, I knew you were doing things you weren't supposed to.
I mean, at least he's been helpful rather than harmful. At least he teleported.
He could have possibly killed you by bringing you here.
I mean...
Well, he didn't, and we're gonna lift the curse, so everything's all good.
Exactly, so we...
Well, I don't have any faith in you, but good luck.
I at least have faith. I mean,
you're a paladin, that doesn't count.
Oh, okay. Now that is classist. You know that. Right? Now that is classist.
Now you're sounding like the rogue. Filthy thieves.
Okay, I'm sorry, but him getting a little sticky-handed with my bag wouldn't put it past me.
I am not a thief rogue. I specialize in assassinations.
Yeah,
so you steal lives.
Well, you put it that way, I guess I am.
Get the hell out of here!
See, and I have patience, shoot.
The chimera starts to advance.
I'll be back when you have babies.
She kind of looks over at she kind of waves at the chimera before kindly taking her leave with her bag.
The Abra sits on it.
And then the Abra just with the chimera.
Pretty much. Son of a bitch! Get back here! You did this to 3 chimeras this week!
In which Chloe's like, oh my. Now, I'm not held responsible for that.
I swear to God, if I ever catch you, I will flush you down the toilet like I should have when you were born.
Oh, Axel, I love you so much.
The side characters and plots for comedy, like, that's the thing. I'm a comedy D&D writer. I am not a terror. Like, I can do horror and stuff and they're fine, but I'm good at writing comedy D&D on the fly.
Yeah.
That is, I can make a character memorable. I can give them a personality that interacts and is recurring and fluid.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It doesn't feel forced because the characters just act like they're supposed to.
And then I managed to make a character that's probably, at this point, probably done with everybody's shit and just wants to be left alone at this point.
Well, there's a lot of, pretty much every character any of you guys meet at this point, they're just like, we're so done with their shit.
Yeah. And Chloe's going to agree with that to some degree.
Also, I want to give you guys a spoiler. You guys aren't going to see anybody else in town. There's word out that someone is just feeding people to mimics in the streets. So everybody is barred and locked their doors. You are not going to meet a single other person during this adventure in this town.
To be fair, Chloe didn't do shit.
I didn't say you did, I'm just giving you a heads up.
I know. By the end of it, once the fog's lifted, they're gonna wanna come out to see the fog at least.
Oh, there's gonna be some interest. Like, I can't wait to see the afterwards of this because it just starts off like, alright, we just burned down town, let's go to we're just gonna fuck this one up too. Alright, well, next town maybe?
Hopefully.
Like, we're still level 5 because we can't fucking get past the town bullshit.
Because someone keeps burning down the damn place. It wasn't Chloe.
Here's the thing.
I didn't die.
Sure you didn't.
You just told the mimic to eat the people.
Exactly.
I just told him to sick the bartender and the barmaid. I didn't tell him to kill everyone. Fucking town.
Fair enough. That was definitely severe, but you started that shit.
I know, right?
Alright. Like, well, I think that's good on my recording. I gotta stop the recording and get ready for my next stream, but holy shit, that was funny and fun.
But I didn't do it.